Throughout all of our discussion, we've seen that assumptions are critical to doing causal inference. Even in randomized experiments, which are often held up as the gold standard of causal inference, we had to make loads of assumptions. We assumed that the policy we're interested in is the one that's present in the experiment, and that ethical concerns did not prevent us from running the experiment in the first place, that we measured the true outcome of interest and not a proxy variable, that subjects perfectly complied with the treatment assignment. Okay, they did what we wanted them to do. And finally, that there were no spillover effects, that me getting treated didn't affect the outcomes of other people who were not treated. Okay, so we had to make all of these assumptions to actually do our analysis for experiments. Now, nonetheless, experiments are still better than many of the other methods we use because we get our variation in the treatment assignments at random, whereas in other methods, we usually had to assume that. Okay, and those other methods also have these problems we mentioned about spillovers and proxy variables, et cetera. So these are issues that can come up in regressions and instrumental variables, differences and differences, regression is continuity. Okay, so experiments are very good, but they're not going to solve every problem we have. We do still need to make some assumptions to draw any conclusions. In these other methods, we had to make these stronger assumptions than you need in experiments. So for example, in regression, we had to assume that all confounders were accounted for, okay? That we could control for everything that could possibly affect your outcome, and then just learn what the effect of treatment is once we've controlled for all these confounders. Okay? We had to assume that we had all of the confounders in our data. For instrumental variables, remember we had these three main assumptions. The instrument had to be randomly assigned, that's exogeneity. The instrument can't affect outcomes directly, that's exclusion. And the instrument has to affect the treatment variable directly, that's relevance. For differences and differences in panel data, we had to assume that changes in the treatment assignment over time are randomly assigned. That's the common trends assumption. And finally, for regression discontinuity, we had to assume that the cutoff only mattered for determining treatments and not for anything else, that no other unobserved variables were changing across this cutoff. Okay? So we had to make all these assumptions in all these different methods in order to get any conclusions. And there's actually an even more basic point. If we're going to predict the impact of implementing a new policy tomorrow, then we're going to always have to assume that in some sense tomorrow is going to be like today, and tomorrow is going to be like yesterday, because we're using data from today and yesterday to predict the future. Okay, so we have to assume at least there's some constancy over time, or else we're just going to be up a creek without a paddle.